श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्यः कवितार्किक केसरी वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्ताम् सदा हृदि स्वादयन्निह सर्वेषाम् त्रय्यन्तार्थम् सुदुर्ग्रहम् स्तोत्रयामास योगीन्द्रः तम् वन्दे यामुनाह्वयम् नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः यत्पदाम्भोरुहध्यान विध्वस्ताशेषकल्मषः वस्तुतामुपयातोऽहम् यामुनेयम् नमामि तम्
श्रीमत्कृष्ण समात्वाय नमो यामुन सूनवे यत्कटाक्ष एकलक्ष्याणाम् सुलभः श्रीधरः सदा नमः यामुन पाद अब्ज रेणुभिः पावित आत्मने विदित अखिल वेद्याय गुरवे विदित आत्मने नमः अचिन्त्य अद्भुत अक्लिष्ट ज्ञान वैराग्य राशये नाथाय मुनये अगाध भगवत भक्ति सिंधवे
तदहं त्वदृतेन नाथवान् मदृते त्वं दयनीयवान् च विधि निर्मित मेत मन्वयं भगवन् पालय मास्म जीहपः.
So the same idea that we had in the previous verse, among the people who are to be taken pity on, I am the foremost, otherwise you will not get a better one. That was the statement of Sri Yamanacharya in the previous verse. The same word dayaniyaha was there. So you will have no better devotee than me, dayaniyaha. Here it is dayaniyavan. So dayaniyaha refers to the devotee, dayaniyavan refers to the Lord. So Keshavdas Swami to read me.
Therefore without thee, I have not my Lord, and without me, thou hast not a worthy recipient for thy compassion. Preserve this relation, O Lord, ordained by fate, and spurn me not.
Beautiful word, spurn. So we say, therefore. That is a word in Sanskrit, tat, therefore. Tat has many meanings. Tat means it, that. Tat means hence, so, therefore. For that sake, tat also can join a compound and say kiss or its something. So here, tat means therefore. So, aham, I, na nathavan, I have no Lord. Na Nathavan, Nathavan, Nathaha Lord, Master. Nathavan is one who is with the Master. So Na Nathavan is, if you take it this Tamil word also which we use, Anadai. Anadai we use in Tamil. Anathaha Sankara. Draupadi called herself Anatha. Anatham Kim Upekshas. कृष्ण द्वारकावासी काशी यादव नंदन इमाम अवस्थाम संप्राप्ताम अनाथाम वी हैव टू से अनाथम संप्राप्तम अनाथम तो ननाथे ननाथमान तो आई हैव नो गाइड हु व्हेन त्वद्रते विदाउट यू इज अ स्पेशल एक्सप्रेशन. The word vritte will go with only another word, only in a compound. So, tad vritte. That means tattaha rite, without me. Sans you, I have no Lord, I have no Master. Madrite, if you leave me, that means without me, tvam dayaniyaman, you have nobody to take pity on. Tvam, you, dayaniyaman, a pitiful, graceful, compassionate. You are not compassionate without me. As though there is only one master, that is evident, obvious. Why? There is only one master. But there is only one devotee even. Without me, so you are not a leader. You are not a guide. You have no post as guide because I am not there. And so I am without me, Madrate, Tvam Dau, as not a worthy recipient. Sanskrit word has been translated as worthy recipient. There is no word for worthy recipient there in Sanskrit. That is only me. It is only me. Thou has not. Not me as for thy compassion. Of course, without me is there already, the word without me is there. So you need not mention. So there is no word for worthy recipient, the translator has added. Because only a worthy recipient will receive the blessings. Not everyone. But generally it is said also, as you ask the question, what about the uneducated? Those who cannot read books, then those who do not know how to involve themselves in devotion, they do not know how to do activities which are prescribed in the scripture. No karma yoga, no jnana yoga, no bhakti yoga. No prapatti yoga also. I don't know how to surrender. I don't know a topic called surrender. I have not heard. How much kilo is the surrender? If I ask this question, I am illiterate. I am ignorant. Even that particular individual soul is blessed by the Lord. So that you must remember. The Lord is merciful to all. No partiality, no differentiation of status. You are not judged by your status, your financial position, your knowledge, your performance of activities. Nothing counts. Only one thing is important, namely kripa, the grace of the Lord. So anybody can get his grace at any time. Now, Parasara Bhatta follows Dhammacharya. He says in his Gunaratna Kosham, Vidhidat Kritasi, the same word from Dhammacharya. Vidhidat Kritasi. There are two shades of meaning here. Fate, if you say fate, Vidhi means fate. Vidhi means Brahma, the creator is called Vidhi. Vidhi means rule. You know that Vidhi means rule. So you say, what is the word? Oh Lord, ordained by fate. So let us, fate in Tamil, situation, we understand fate is negative. Fate means negative. We never say, I am lucky because of my fate. I am fortunate because of my fate. We don't say in Tamil. If you can understand, if English people can understand this way, positive aspect of fate, it's very good. But we never attach anything bad, positive to fate. Fate means fatal. He says the word fatal. He gave a fatal blow. So he says fate. So fatal is very serious, negative. Therefore, we don't say ordained by fate, ordained by Brahma, you can say ordained by creator. I'm not saying it to change the word fate, but vidhihi, fate, vidhihi, creator. So can you say this way? Because without any shelter, any other shelter, I resort to you. That was the question earlier by me, earlier also. If we have a shelter, another shelter, better than Lord Sriman Narayana, shall we go? That is the question. So sometimes we always misunderstand that all other deities will be able to protect us without the help of Sriman Narayana. Therefore, it is not a negative statement here, as we mean it in Tamil. Parashara Bhattar says, you are ordained by fate to protect me. Viditakritasi. Oh, Goddess Ranganayika, you must protect me because you have no other way. You have no other way. So, vidhi nirmitam, nirmitam fixed, established, etam anvayam, this relation. Etam anvayaha has got three meanings. One is relationship, the other is prose order, the other is family. Anvayaha means family. So, you and I are in one family. Oh, Sriman Narayana, tava asmi. I belong to you. I am a member of your family. You are my mother. You are my father. You are my guide. You are my teacher. You are my everything. You are my wealth. You are my education. You are my friend. So you must not leave me. So, hey Bhagavan, remember the same meaning. Six qualities in forefront and all other auspicious qualities, numberless, in infinity. So, hey Bhagavan, O Lord, so palaya, please protect me. The word is preserve, the word is preserve, very good, beautifully given. Palaya means preserve. Take care of. Rule over me. Prajapalanam, we say, with regard to the duty of a king. He has to take care of the subject. So take care of me. Palaya. So again, the beauty in this particular verse is Ma can be taken twice. So palaya ma meaning take care of me. So you can also have a negative statement. Don't take care of me. Ma palaya is don't take care of me. Alvar said he went to a place called Mayavaram, today called Mayiladuthurai. And he went to a Divya Kshetram called Thiru Indalu. There the Lord's name is Parimala Ranganatha. He is a sweet-smelling Ranganatha. And Shanta Madam may know the place also. And when he went to the temple, the temple was closed, not out of pandemic, but normal hours. So normal, non-working hours, it was closed. So he came and saw the door closed. He got disappointed. because he could not have the darshan of the Lord. Therefore he said, Nere vaazhndhu pom. You live happily. You live happily. You don't allow me to live happily. You live happily. Nere vaazhndhu pom. Out of fiend anger, you can say. Out of fiend anger. False anger. False fury. He said, Nere vaazhndhu pom. So this is how we... So suppose we say, Ma Pale, don't take care of me. Don't take care of me in the sense, I don't bother. I don't bother whether you take care of me or not. So in that way also you can interpret differently. Why I say this is, the Sanskrit expression gives rise to so many shades of meaning. Then please understand that Maasma Jihapaha is a peculiar way of what you call a verb. Peculiar way of a verb. Generally, when we know the basic grammar in Sanskrit, we will understand the word sma will be used only in a present tense verb, which makes it past. The meaning will be in past tense, whereas the word sma will be added. It's a particle in Sanskrit. The word is called the particle, a small word, one aksharam, one syllable. So when we add to a present tense verb, it becomes past tense. For example, palayati, palayati, take palayati, present tense verb. Palayati means he takes care of. So palayati sma meaning he took care of. Past tense. So that is the meaning of that particle. That's the work of this particle. When you add this letter to the present tense verb, it doesn't change the present tense verb into a past tense verb, but it gives past tense meaning. So also we have another word in Sanskrit. You know the word, yavat, yavat. Generally, yavat meaning till, until, as far as. So that is the meaning of yavat, until then. The word yavat, when it is added with a present tense verb, it gives future tense meaning. Suppose I say, yavat palayati, yavat palayati. That means he will protect me. He will protect. He will take care of. And also another word that you may know, pura, pura meaning in olden time, long, long ago. We say the word is long, long ago. Once upon a time. There are two letters, pura, P-U-R-A-A, pura. So when you add it with present tense verb, then it gives future tense meaning. These are all some what you call shortcut tricks to use a verb when we do not, when we forget or when we do not know the past tense form. When we do not know the past tense form, we can use this. And when we want to compose poetry, we can use this. When we want for exigency, emergency situation, you can use this. All the three I mean. So, yavat or pura added to a present tense verb gives future tense meaning. Sma added to a present tense verb gives the past tense meaning. So, why I say all these things? The beauty in Sanskrit. But, maasma jihapaha will be. So, don't let me down. Don't let me down. Don't leave me in lurch. Here the root is ha, H-A-A. The letter G and pa join that. So the root is ha, to leave. So ma ha, ha to meaning don't leave. Don't leave me. Spurn me not. Don't turn me out. Don't turn me out. Maasma jihapa. Now, if you take the word anvayam, Anvayam, so you can take the word like this. You are the devotee in the family, but don't leave my family. Don't give up my family. We are all selfish. We have been saying, I am your devotee, I am the best devotee, I am the foremost devotee, and so on. So please protect my family also. Anvayam. Anvayam is family. This is the beauty of this verse. So, Palaya Masma Jihapaha, please protect me. The English translation says, preserve this relation. So, preserve is the word for Palaya. And Masma Jihapaha, spurn me not. Now, the beauty here again, please remember, the word Ma means me. Ma means me. In another context, don't is the meaning of the word ma. And then here it is me. So again, so three times you can take the word ma. Three times. This is a rule in Sanskrit. This is a rule in Sanskrit. Whenever there is a word which should be taken to get so many meanings, you are allowed, you are free to use many times the same word. This is what happened in a WhatsApp message. There was a verse. And the verse was given by someone of my friends. And then one Sanskrit scholar, professor, Dr. K. Srinivasan, principal and head of the department of Sanskrit, Vivekananda College, Chennai, pointed out one mistake. Then immediately I wrote to the group, WhatsApp group, who will find out one mistake? One boy, he must be 40 or 45. He is related to me and he said, There are two mistakes. And thirdly, that scholar again came to my WhatsApp. And then there are three mistakes. So what I say is, then again in translation into English, this boy said that if there is the fourth mistake. Then the fourth mistake was this, namely, you cannot take ma second time, third time, and so on. Here, you can take third time ma. That is the beauty in them. I think, you see, Amanacharya's verse only will show like this. Three times. So ma means me, that means for me, not. So maasma jihapaha, not, N-O-T. Ma means N-O-T. So, me and not are given by two times ma. And already you take palaya ma, take care of me. Again, ma anvayam palaya, so protect my family also. How? Look at the Sanskrit words. Now again, Vidhi Nirmitam, I want to again repeat the word. Vidhi Nirmitam Yatam Anvayam. Do you feel fortunate, lucky or unfortunate or unlucky to have a relationship with God? Yeah, we feel always lucky. We always, so we are, it is in a positive sense. Fate has favored me. You must say that. Not ordained by fate, favored by fate. That should be the right. So instead of ordained by fate, nirmitam can mean anything. So ordained, instead of ordained, you can also write favored by fate. You need not delete ordained, favored by fate. That should be the positive thinking. Because I am fortunate to associate myself with you, O Lord. That means that must be our attitude. It is said that in Sanskrit also in somewhere that we have to take many births before getting into the groove of devotion. Today we can say you and I are fortunate that we are going through Swataratnam because fate has favored. I told a lady, I cannot teach you this. Why I said is not because I am not capable of doing it, but because it is impossible at this age to remember, memorize a prose work. I told you already. So I don't like to teach. Therefore, in the sense, what is the problem? God has, the fate has not favored me on that particular stotra. That is what we say. When I reject a stotra, then I'm unfortunate. That's what I must be. No, fate has favored me that I'm not ready to teach. No. And that's it. So let us take the comment. Let's go to the Madhava, right? Bhagavan. So again, the first quality is mentioned here. Jnanam nirindavanana embermani. Generally, as we know, you take the subject of the sentence initially and then go to the other words. So the second preference is verb. Then third preference is all other words. Adjective. So, jnanam nirindavanana embermani. So now, Padavare wants to put it in order, anmayaha. So, hey Bhagavan. That is therefore, adalal therefore, aham adiyen. The word aham na natava. Sadrite, without you. Unnai tavaran vodruke, unnai tavaran. Okay, except you. Na nathavan, vera nathan arthavan. So I don't have any other protector, any other leader, any other guide, any other friend. So tamcha niyum, you too. Madrate, without me, you don't have a better devotee. Na dayaniyavan. Aruluku vishayamaha udayai allai. So there is no one else so deserving, so fit for receiving your grace within Irmitam. Now you see the positive statement in Harivachandra, right? Un arulale erpatta. That you must say, see it in English also. So within Irmitam also means because of blessings from you. Unnarulale. Who is Vidhi? Vidhi, as I told you, initial meaning is Vidhi fate, Vidhi Brahma, Vidhi rule, and so on. I think you must see the name in Vishwasahasranamam. I think it should be available in Vishwasahasranamam. Vidhi. Find out, that is your homework. So, etad anvayam, in the sambandhattai. So it is a relationship, so, same thing. So in the sambandha, palaya. So it is a rakshitu kol. Tamil word is little more stress, with a little more stress. You keep me safe. That means you keep my keep me as a devotee without losing me. Don't lose me. If you lose me, then you will have no devotee. Then Master Jihapaha Kai Vittu Vida Vendam. Now I told you, in a particular verb, like what you call imperative mood in Sanskrit, Lot Lakaraha in Sanskrit, we have six meanings. And here we find one of the meanings, namely, do not leave me. I order you. I give you a, what do you call, I give you an unescaping order. You cannot escape from my order. Unescaping instruction. Diligently you follow my instruction. Merit, Tamil la merit, he is threatening. So don't leave me. I will turn the hand off. Don't despond me out. Avatarika. Tadaham. So ippidi dayaniya dayamangalana iruvarkum mukhyamana சம்பந்தம் தானும் தேவதையுடைய கிருப்பையாலே ஆகும். இண்டிவிஜுவல் போல் லைக் யாமுனாச்சார். So he combined both of them as seeing a pair of two people, namely, one is God and the other is, one is the protector and another is the protected, or one who deserves protection. So, dayaniyaha, dayavan. So, iruvarkum, mukhyamana is sambandham. This is the important relationship, the most important relationship. தேவரையருடைய கிருப்பையாலே ஆயிடும். ஈவன் திஸ் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் ஹேப்பன்ட் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் யுவர் கிரேஸ். தேவரையருடைய கிருப்பையாலே ஆயிடும். திஸ் இஸ் த ரிசல்ட் அவர் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் இஸ் த ரிசல்ட் ஆஃப் யுவர் கிரேஸ். யூ ஆர் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிள் ஃபார் இஃபெக்டிங் திஸ் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் அண்ட் தேர்ஃபோர் யூ மஸ்ட் ப்ரொடெக்ட். ஆன பின்பு இதை கைவிடாதே ரட்சித்தருளர். பிளீஸ் ரிமெம்பர், யாமனாச்சாரியா இஸ் வெரி ஹம்பிள். யூ கேனாட் சே ஐ ஐ டோல் யூ ஜஸ்ட் நவ் ஹி ஆர்டர்ட் த லாட், ஹி ஆர்டர்ஸ் த லாட். டோன்ட் லீவ் மீ ஷவுட்டிங் ஷவுட்டிங் அட் ஹிம். ஹி இஸ் ஆல்சோ த்ரெட்டனிங், இஃப் யூ டோன்ட் கெட் மீ then you will have no devotee in future. You will have no better devotee in future. So it is not a question of threatening. This is where you find a particular verse in Kalidasa, Abhijnana Shakuntalam, a drama. There are seven acts, A-C-T-S. There are seven acts. And in the fourth act, one important verse is there. And sage Kashyapa, otherwise called Kanva, who is the foster father, F-O-S-T-E-R, foster father of Shakuntala. Shakuntala is the daughter of Vishwamitra, the sage, and Menaka, the celestial nymph. So he, Kanva sends a message. To the king Dushyanta. King Dushyanta has sent a message. I am sending my daughter to you. Keep her, maintain her as your first wife. You must have had a lot of wives so far. He says, Bhagu Vallabaha Rajana. The kings practiced polygamy in those days. Even today, the leaders also practice polygamy. So many wives. Dasaratha 60,000 wives he sent because he was afraid of Parashurama. Therefore, so here Dushyanta is sent a message by Kanva. Now you please understand, there is what we call a figure of speech called in Sanskrit, beauty in Sanskrit, embellishment in Sanskrit called Kaku. K-A-A-K-U. Kaku. Kaku means you change your tone. Kaku means tone. A change of tone. By change of tone, you can either command or show your humility. Kanva says a particular verse. If you want, I will give you later the particular verse. So, if you say it in a low tone, in a low decibel, if you say it, it's a humble statement. You are a king. I am one of the subjects. Therefore, you please listen to me. Treat my daughter equally along with all your wives. That is a humble request. Then if you change the tone, O king, if you do not treat properly my daughter, I will curse you. I am a sage. Don't think that we have no general knowledge of the world. But if you make any mistake in connection with my daughter, I will take you to task. So this is the tone. By tone you can change the meaning. This is what we call kaku. And therefore because of the kaku, because of the change of tone, you can understand that it is a command or a humble request. And this is what we call in Sanskrit also, as you know, double entendre in French, namely double meaning, pun, P-U-N, sileda in Tamil, slesha in Sanskrit. So this is how, so you can take Yamanacharya's statement like this, low tone, humble request from Rama Yamanacharya. So read this verse differently. Tadaham, starting with Tadaham. Tadaham. Tadrite na nathavan. Say it humbly in a low tone. Tadaham, Tadrite na nathavan. Madrite, Dayaniya, Dayava. And say it aloud. Say it. Tadaham Tvadrite Na Nathavan. So you say it aloud. So you get two meanings. So there is humble request as well as commanding voice. This is the beauty in I think we will see some first few words of that channel. Otherwise, now you can also have a question session. So this is the last okay. So we will take up the paragraph. So Adalal, that is therefore, Dayaniya Devarikku Dur Labhamana Pindu. So if I am a rare devotee to you, as one who has to be taken care of, Aham Saparadhanai. The word Aham, as I told you just now, if you say it in a low tone, that means you have committed some mistake. Saparadhanai. I have committed a lot of follies. I have made a lot of errors. I have committed a lot of blunders. Saparadhanai. Therefore I say Aham in a low tone. Aham. Anutapam Pirandanam. Now in Tamil, it is a mistaken, the meaning is mistaken. Anutapam is not pity. Anutapam is not pity according to Tamil. Then according to Tamil, we mean it is as pity. Ayo pavam, anutapam padugiren. Sanskrit word, Sanskrit means regret later. Regret later is called anutapa. It means suffering later. I have committed a mistake, therefore I repent. The repentance is called anutapa. I feel very bad for my own action. So that is anutapa. Now 196, because the words are there only, anutapam piranda non. When I say aham, now that after committing a mistake, not one mistake, I am committing a lot of mistakes. Then I am now regretful. I am regretful. Now I realize that I must not have committed the mistake. 193. Brisham Bhavati Dukshitaha. This is a statement from Ramayana by Rama. So he said, so also it can apply to Krishna Avatara also. It is a Rama Avatara statement. If the subjects, people in his country, namely Ayodhya capital, Kosala Rajyam, are suffering, then he also suffers along with them. Rama also suffers along with them. He feels the sorrow. He understands the pains of the people. So, Brisham Bhavati Dukkitaha. Maybe the suffering of the people is less, whereas the suffering of Rama is more. Brisham. Brisham means much, much more than the people. This is one of the best qualities of Rama. And again, we will ask, is it enough that the king is sorrowful, he is sad because of our suffering? No, he must take immediately the remedy. Take remedial action. That's very important. He will do it. Rama will do it. So, Prisham Bhavati Dukhi. So, because he saw that all the sages in the forest are suffering because of the demon's attack, he went to the forest for 14 years, annihilated so many demons, Viradha, Kabandha, for many people. Krishna Avatara also, you find that Putana, Rama Avatara Tataka, Tataka's son Subahu, afterwards Maricha, who came in the form of a deer. So all these demons have had to be finished for the sake of the sages. So he went and protected. So in Krishna Avatara, starting with Putana, Bakasura, Aghasura, Chakatasura, so many demons. So many demons were killed in order that Gokulam people will remain, live peacefully. So here, and Dukhyana Ennilum. So, no, I am feeling the suffering he did. Since you feel one with me in sorrowful situation, so though I am suffering, you suffer more. You are not able to tolerate my suffering. So what is the name of the Lord? Paradukha Asakishnu. Read it in this way. Paradukha Asakishnu. Para, another person, stranger, third person, so on. It also means the enemy. When Ravana stood weaponless, Nirayudhapani, he was asked to go back. Indra poi nadeva. Go back and come tomorrow prepared for the war. He took pity on Ravana. Para dukkha asahishnu. Para, another person, dukkha, suffering. Asahishnu, one who cannot bear. Sahishnu, one who can tolerate. Asahishnu. The Visarga is there in Sanskrit. Para dukkha asahishnu. Tvam ire dayai. Asahishnu tvam ire dayai. Your pity is conspicuously noted by your intolerance to others' suffering. Madhrite tvam dayaniyamannacha dayaika rakshanana ennai olindalum. Even though you live, can avoid me, devaridaya kripai குமார் இருந்து போமித்தன் யுவர் யுவர் ஓன் குவாலிட்டி நேம்லி கிரேஸ் கம்பேஷன் வில் நாட் அலவ் யூ டு கோ அவே ஃப்ரம் மீ இட் வில் ட்ரபிள் யூ டு சே ஹே கோ அண்ட் ப்ரொடெக்ட் யுவர் டிவோட்டி கோ அண்ட் ப்ரொடெக்ட் யுவர் டிவோட்டி இட் வில் ரிமைண்ட் யூ யுவர் குவாலிட்டி நேம்லி கம்பேஷன் வில் ரிமைண்ட் யூ And then Eta Dhanvayam within him. We will take up this session words later. Oruvarai oliya oruvarukku chellada, then the sentence is incomplete in this page, and therefore we will take it up in the next.
Swadayanniha sarvesham trayantartham sudurgraham stotrayamasa yogindraha तं वंदे यामुनाह्वयम् नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः यत्पदाम्भोरुहध्यान विध्वस्ता शेषकल्मषः वस्तुतामुपयातोऽहम् यामुनेयं नमामितम्
श्रीमत्कृष्ण समात्वाय नमो यामुन सूनवे यत्कटाक्ष एकलक्ष्याणां सुलभः श्रीधरः सदा नमः यामुन पाद अब्ज रेणुभिः पावित आत्मने विदित अखिल वेद्याय गुरवे विदित आत्मने
कवितार्किक सिंहाय कल्याण गुणशालिने श्रीमते वेंकटेशाय वेदांत गुरवे नमः।